I'm Vikram Merchant. I'm Director of Rio Tinto Diamond Sales and Marketing for India. Rio Tinto is a multi-commodity mining company, and we are amongst the different product groups that we have. Diamonds is also an important part. We are an important supplier of diamonds, a producer of diamonds, as now is becoming common knowledge, 9 out of 10 diamonds, in fact 13 out of every 14 diamonds, so that's more than 90% of diamonds, are cut and polished in India, which is why Rio Tinto, India is so important to Rio Tinto's diamond business, as it is for the retail jeweler. And with so much of the world's German jewelry industry being based out of India, of course this is an industry that brings a huge amount of revenue to the Indian exchequer. But it's not just export markets. Today, India is, of course, a rapidly growing consumer market with a rising middle class, but also a young consumer. Jewelry is now, of course, a very important part of that consumer market. So, whereas previously perhaps jewelry was about exports, India today is now a very thriving and it's a very important market, which again is the importance of the retail jeweler awards. The retail jeweler, while it is a magazine that has been supporting and actually a source of information to the gems and jewelry trade in India, you know, they have been actually one of the leaders in also leading change and bringing change to the industry. And clearly change in design, in innovation, in the way jewelry is presented to consumers is part of that. The Retail Jeweler Awards is actually the first part of, and today was the jury event, which will be followed by then the selection of winners and then the actual award ceremony. But today is the day that we can see the jewelry designs that have come from all over India, from jewelers, from designers, you know, what has driven their inspirations, the themes that engage them, how that is interpreted into jewelry design. All of that is on showcase here. And it's on showcase again because Retail Jeweler has developed this award ceremony, which I believe is in its 11th year now. So that is fantastic that it's actually grown and now become a part of our jewelry calendar. Our Rio Tinto diamond business, our strategy is working together with our customers who buy rough diamonds from us, who cut and polish them, some of them set into jewelry, and some of them even work further downstream in retail. But our strategy has always been to work together with our customers and our downstream partners in adding value to the diamonds and in creating demand for the products that we produce. So in India, our strategy has been again to work with our partners in India, our customers in India, and engage with their downstream partners. Retail Jeweler, of course, has been doing this, and while Retail Jeweler, as the name suggests, is far away from the world of mining, but because we are working further downstream with our customers and in turn their supply chain partners, we work together with Retail Jeweler when it comes closer to the consumer, and as we engage closer to the consumer, you know, this is where we are working together with Retail Jeweler. So we have been associating closely with them, firstly in sharing information, in fact offering information as well to the industry, where Retail Jeweler, their trade magazine, becomes for us firstly a source of information but also a means of communication to the trade. Partnering in this initiative in the jewelry awards, which we've been doing now for a few years, really has come from that association, that we see that firstly the need for such a recognition in the jewelry industry, that there is awards firstly that create recognition but then also drive innovation and change. So, you know, we really see that it's a good partnership. It's a partnership that is taking the industry forward. It's a great platform for us to communicate our ideas, for us to be part of that change, to help that change along. So it's a great partnership, Rio Tinto and Retail Jewel Up. I am seeing year on year that there has been something new, and that the jewelers and the designers that are offering their designs for the award process actually now are giving it more thought, whereas previously they may have just pulled out couture pieces that were in stock. I think now there is actually a lot of thought that goes into designing. So I would say certainly that has been an evolution that the awards have brought to jewelry design development in India. So I think that process really starts, I mean, if the awards, the judging is done now in June with the onset of the monsoon, the jewelry designer is already thinking of this in January and actually thinking, what are the kind of, you know, what should be our theme this year? Which is the category I should be working with? What could be my inspiration? And, you know, so there's a great deal more thought. And I think it's exactly that, because the thought that they put into these designs ultimately enables them, motivates them to then translate that into more commercial pieces that we will find in jewelry stores. So really, I believe the Retail Jeweler Awards is actually driving that. Rio Tinto has been developing its flagship Indian marketing initiative, Nazrana. And that is the brand you see associated with the Retail Jeweler Awards. It's Nazrana, the diamond gift that has been the sponsor of the Retail Jeweler Awards. Nazrana has been built around this, our cultural affinity to gifting. As Indians, gifts are so important to us. We're a generous people. And Nazrana actually offers the alternative of diamond jewelry gifting. It celebrates the gift giver. Nazrana also offers fantastic, trendy, fashionable designs for self-purchase. And at the accessible price points, because as a gift, you must be affordable, you must be accessible to offer as gifts. It's also a very, it's a super entry point to diamond purchase for a new young Indian consumer. So it starts an early engagement with diamond jewelry. It offers diamond jewelry that expresses personal taste and style, and it's an extremely affordable, accessible gifting option. So we've been developing this brand in India. We've been growing it, evolving it. What we bring today with the brand is this wonderful concept, theme-based collections. So we have actually widened that palette of cultural design inspirations, and we have 7 theme-based collections that we're offering. We're creating collections, we have a unique presentation where we are presenting jewelry in store by theme-based collections rather than being product-based. So we understand that jewelry is about self-expression. As a gift as well, it must express not just the gift giver, but also the one you're gifting to. So design is so important. And we are presenting our jewelry in store by theme-based collections. So you have a range of products, all with a consistent design element. The brand, while it may be accessible, is also aspirational. There is an N logo that has been integrated into the design of all the pieces. So Nazrana is very distinctive. It's a distinctive brand that is at a price point that makes it a wonderful gift, but it also has a range of themes that express different consumer styles, taste, cultural needs, all expressed through these theme-based collections. Rio Tinto Diamonds congratulates Retail Jeweler as they move into their 11th year of this retail jeweler design contest and awards. We've had now a significant journey together with Retail Jeweler, and Rio Tinto and its flagship brand Nasrana have had a wonderful association. We are, together with Retail Jeweler, looking to increase innovation, to bring in new thoughts, a new presentation, and a new offering to consumers in India. And we see that the Retail Jeweler Awards is inspiring and motivating the jewelry, the gems and jewelry industry, into creating these new offerings, expanding and pushing at the envelope to offer Indian consumers, who are now an evolving group, wonderful, fantastic designs.